5 players, 5 skid steers, a giant maze, and hundreds of hours of footage and computer animated shots. What's going on, everyone? Wayne here. Welcome into Equipment World. You know, there's a lot going on in Caterpillar's latest incredible cat trial video, which brought a massive game of Pac-Man to life. Now, in a previous video, we covered the maze itself in detail, how Caterpillar carved a massive trench maze out of the earth. So if you haven't seen that video already, please check that out right now or after you get done watching this one. The maze is a marvel in and of itself. And obviously, if you haven't seen Caterpillar's Pac-Man trial video, check that out right now before you get into this one. But in this video right here, we're really going to focus on the very special version of Pac-Man that Caterpillar has created. So if you're curious what it was like operating a skid steer in the largest game of Pac-Man ever, or what it took to animate Pac-Man into the real world, we've got the answers for you right here. Let's get into it. Now, for the players, Cat invited a fairly eclectic group of people to take part in the Pac-Man trial. Playing the role of the ghosts were YouTube gaming creator Blitz Kriegsler, Instagram equipment star Tom Gardocki, aka the Dirt Ninja, contractor Alfonso Fajardo, and esports stock car driver Joey Stone. And the role of Pac-Man was played by Jim Cosner, the owner of Gymax Group of Illinois, a landscaping and demolition contractor.
When I first got the email from Archie, I had the biggest smile on my face, and he said, "Hey, let's have a Zoom call or whatever." And it took all I had not to be just jumping out of my seat, so excited to be a part of it. But no, it was pretty amazing, especially, you know, I could tell you about every one of those videos, and everybody at my company and most everybody in the construction industry has seen these Built4It videos. And then to be a part of it, let alone become Pac-Man in it, I mean, that was an amazing opportunity. And I was very excited. Still am.
Now, just based on their backgrounds, it's pretty clear that most of the guys chosen to play in this giant game of Pac-Man had pretty extensive backgrounds with operating equipment. However, there were two pretty significant wrinkles that the Pac-Man trial was throwing at the players: remote control and this giant maze itself. Now, beyond the power pellets at his disposal, which literally send ghosts running, as someone with extensive experience with remote control skid steer operation in applications like hillside mowing, Pac-Man, aka Jim Cosner, had a decided leg up on his ghost competition.
If you want to know my honest opinion, the remote setup is so much like being in a machine. So we had 3 operators that have all been in skid steers before, as 2 ghosts and then myself, but all 3 of us were easily able to pick up the controls and the operation of the machine because they were able to mimic, you know, actually sitting in the machine so realistically on these controller packs that, you know, you can't hardly even tell other than the perspective of like when it's coming at you, everything's backwards, right? Because you're not sitting in the seat. But that, you know, for sure, the other 2 players that had not had any or hardly any experience in a machine, they had some learning curves of you know, like the first time you were ever in a machine, you know, there's definitely a learning curve there. But for the guys that have ran them, it came to us in 5-10 minutes of running it.
Now, playing the role of Pinky the Ghost in the Pac-Man trial is Blitz Kriegsler. And Blitz is a really interesting guy. For one, he's a former civil engineer in the Army Corps of Engineers. And 2, he grew up around construction sites because his dad owns a residential construction company. So even though Blitz's current awesome job is making gaming videos on YouTube where he has more than 3 million subscribers, construction equipment is not exactly a foreign concept to him.
So I've been around the concrete trucks that have the remote control, the pump trucks with the big booms. I've been around those before, and I didn't realize before this that they've started making the other machines remote control as well. From what I understand and from what it looked like to me, it looked like it was pretty much the same functionality between those boom trucks and the control that we worked with. But I mean, like my typical Xbox controller, it has the 2 thumbsticks and it has just the regular buttons on it. And that's the same thing as we had out there with the remote control for these skid steers. Was there was the two joysticks on it that we could move around, and the controlling the pitch and the the direction, the steering. It was pretty flawless.
Now, despite how quickly comfort with these remote control skid steers came to the players, Cat didn't just throw them in the maze. Instead, they were set up in a practice area at the Edwards facility where the maze was to allow them a day or so to practice before they went and shot the real thing.
I'll tell you, the first day, they kept us away from the maze. We could see the mounds, but I couldn't see the maze. And they said, nope, we're not going to show you that. We're going to have to get video just so you're actually excited. And I mean, that was one of the hardest things. So then it was the next, I think it was the next morning that they took us over there to actually look at it and get our reactions. And I mean, it was, you can't put it into perspective. And I'm sure even the video won't put it into perspective. You come up on that mound and it was, I think, 250 feet by 250 feet or something like that, just dug earth as the Pac-Man puzzle with the, you know, the shipping container coming into the maze and all the corners. It was unreal that you can, you know, imagine something like that and then actually make it.
Now, with the players completely comfortable with the remote control skid steers, it was finally time to play. But maybe the biggest behind the scenes tidbit of this whole production is that the game itself was mostly scripted. After all, because Pac-Man and the ghosts, and more importantly, the power pellets and the fruits and really everything that kind of Pac-Man uses to navigate his way around the maze, because all of those elements were being added in post-production long after the players had left the maze, Cat had to storyboard this whole thing out. So rather than just being cut loose to run around an empty maze, the players took direction from the Cat production crew, pellet by pellet, shot by shot, for the majority of the shoot. But just because there was a script doesn't mean that this whole thing wasn't a challenge for the guys behind the controls. They were still remote operating skid steers from a considerable distance and with attachments on the front end.
You know, my big concern, especially when we came up and all of our machines were in the maze, and you're looking down and there was, you probably had less than a foot of clearance on each side of that machine, maybe a little more, I might be exaggerating, but very tight. And, you know, I knew how delicate these machines can be. You can adjust your travel speeds and all that just from having one already. So, you know, we got our controllers all dialed in, and I was really worried that some of the guys would have had a hard time making the corners and not hitting the walls. And, you know, the other thing they did, they put all these different work tools on them. And, you know, there were some big attachments out there navigating with 2 foot of clearance. But the machine is just a little bit of movement is a little bit of movement in the machine. And you can really maneuver them through the maze perfectly. You know, making the 90s was kind of tight. That was a little more difficult because you, operator 101, you never turn flat turn, right? You don't just turn the track sideways. So that took a little while to get used to, but you know, it was definitely probably one of the more challenging things that I've done with my remote control machine.
Now for the game, all five players were positioned atop an 8-foot berm, and that gave them an overhead view of the maze. And with that 1% grade from top to bottom, which we talked about in our video on how the maze was built, so if you haven't seen that, be sure to check that out. The end result was an over-the-top view of the maze as they played that the players say surprisingly felt pretty similar to playing on an arcade cabinet.
So you had a pretty good line of sight. You know, there were no obstacles that were taller than the rest of the game board, so you could see the top of your machine and all that.
One of the hardest things to adjust to was the line of sight. So a lot of times in games, we always have like a direct vision to our player or our character. In this, there is occasionally times where we turn around a corner and we would lose like the bottom 4.5 feet of the skid steer. So getting the bucket right or getting the attachment right to go around the corner, It was a challenge, I'll say that. There were times where we had accidentally hit the walls, but like you can only do so well. So compared to a game, I would say that's the biggest real life game that I would ever play. It felt very real.
Now, Jim and Blitz did say that Cat did give the players some free time in the maze to just kind of roam around and have fun. And to Blitz's point about how real the game felt, Jim agreed with that, especially once everyone got completely comfortable with the controls and kind of the experience of moving around the maze.
It felt exactly like Pac-Man. And we grew up, you know, my sister and I had a Miss Pac-Man beer or a bar edition, you know, the big old wood chest one. That, I mean, we played so many hours on that machine. And then, you know, to go out here and actually play it full scale was unbelievable. It was just like playing the game.
And while Jim, Blitz, and the rest of the players left the production shoot high on the adrenaline of playing real-life Pac-Man, Cat had a lot of work to do to make sure that the experience translated to viewers of its upcoming Cat trial video to make them feel the exact same thing. To that end, Cat obviously knew when they started production on this whole idea that Pac-Man and the ghosts would have to co-star along with the machines. They were going to have to make an appearance. Here's the rub, though. As iconic as the Caterpillar brand is, Pac-Man is an icon in his own right. So before any dirt was moved on this massive trench maze, Caterpillar was going to have to convince Bandai Namco, the stewards of the Pac-Man brand, to get on board with this massive undertaking. And as you can expect, Bandai Namco takes very seriously the idea that it is protecting a 40-year legacy of Pac-Man whenever these partnerships arise. So whenever they are deciding to work with somebody, they expect a certain level of attention to detail and accuracy to the game and the feel of the game. Thankfully, Caterpillar succeeded in convincing Bandai Namco that this project would show that amount of respect.
The team at Caterpillar, when they first brought us the concept of it, it was a little hard to imagine what it could be. I mean, obviously a ginormous Pac-Man maze that, you know, dug in the dirt and created, and playing that game, it's really hard to envision when you first, when it's first concepted, because nothing like this has ever been done, you know, ever. The one thing that we really appreciated was the attention to detail and the care that they had for the brand. They themselves knew so much about the about the Pac-Man, you know, the brand, the maze, the details, even some of the like kind of Easter eggs and some of the tricks that were in the game. They researched and they knew all of that. They were fans themselves, and that makes that a lot easier. We were thinking that this could be really different, amazing, something that we've never, seen before.
And with Bandai Namco on board, Caterpillar's lead animator on this project, Jeff McAllister, finally had some assistance in accurately bringing Pac-Man and the ghosts, Inky, Pinky, Blinky, and Clyde, to life. So as Jeff created the animations for the characters for this Cat video, he would periodically check in with Bandai Namco to make sure they were happy with their overall look.
We started out when I modeled, I sent some character turnarounds, some models of them, Pac-Man chomping, the ghost floating, eye colors, they would look at that stuff and they would then send back, his eyes need to be this color, or make sure that, that this color's right. And, Blinky looks a little red. Can we, get that color right?
And once Bandai Namco signed off on the look of all these characters, the challenge then becomes how you insert them into a maze full of machines. The whole idea behind this Pac-Man trial video that Caterpillar has put together is that you're watching these machines representing Pac-Man and the ghosts as they work through 256 levels of the iconic game. And that number 256 is extremely important, especially to those who know anything about Pac-Man, because that is the last level of the game. In that level, the game actually glitches out and kind of breaks. And that's represented in Cat's video by dozers coming in all of a sudden and actually dozing the trench down. So the video is clearly trying to tell a story. It's clearly trying to show you the progression of this game. And so, as we stated before, this whole animation process started with storyboards.
I actually built in Cinema a mock maze, to the Pac-Man specs, and kind of tried to animate as much as possible, because, the more obviously visually you can kind of figure out where each person's going to go, who's got to be where, what, kind of understand what pellets are going to be eaten.
And once the maze was built, the Cat production team then turned those storyboards into a production roadmap. But before any kind of animation can be done, you obviously need footage to add animation to. So as Blitz and Jim and the rest of the players played the game, in and around the maze, Cat had a production crew of 25 people shooting footage from traditional cameras, drones, and GoPros. And that crew captured 84 hours of footage for the video editing team to whittle down to just 2 minutes, and for Jeff to basically take what appears to be skid steers running around an empty maze into something that looks like a game of Pac-Man. All right, so to inject the characters into this game, Cat decided to have each character hover over the machine that represented them. And that meant a lot of tracking work for the animation team. Now, the following is a very oversimplified definition of tracking when it comes to video editing, so bear with me. But essentially, you've got an object that's moving through the frame. In this case, you have skid steers, and with tracking, you're typically trying to attach a graphic of some kind. In this case, Pac-Man or the ghost, you're trying to attach that graphic to the real-life object that's moving through the frame. And that really requires sometimes a lot of frame-by-frame editing by hand to make that effect possible. And that was definitely the case in this video for Jeff and his team. So at the end of the day, what you get is Jeff's incredible animation paired with great video editing, great footage, and Caterpillar's attention to detail. The result of all those things coming together was a group of players got to come together and play a real-life game of Pac-Man. And for us, we all got a smile near the end of what's been a pretty rough year. All right, guys, that's going to wrap up our look at what it was like to play in and animate the largest game of Pac-Man ever played, a game that was played and built with Cat Machines. Just want to take a second to say thank you to all the folks at Caterpillar that let me in as an observer on this process. It was a ton of fun. And also thank you to Jim and Blitz. Be sure to check out Jim's company, Gymax, at their website, and head over to YouTube. If you're here, head over to Blitz's channel to check out the incredible content that he's creating on a daily basis. Hey, but like I mentioned earlier, the animation and the gameplay, that's not the whole story. You definitely want to check out our video on how Cat built the maze itself. We go into really, really deep detail on the machines used and the tools used to make that whole thing possible. So if you haven't already, be sure to check that video out. You can find a link in the description below or above me in the card. And finally, if you like this video, do us a favor and hit that like button below. It really helps our channel out. And if you want more coverage of heavy equipment, be sure to head over to our website at equipmentworld.com and subscribe to our daily newsletter. And if you haven't already, subscribe to us right here on YouTube and hit the bell. Turn on notifications so you're not missing any of our future equipment videos. Thank you guys so much for watching. We really appreciate your time, and we'll see you in the next one.